I was 16. I was living out of home. I moved to Sydney to play football in the NPL there. I was from 𝙞𝙩'𝙨, so to be able to pursue a career in professional football, you definitely had to move away from home. And I started to develop really bad anxiety. I was having panic attacks and I didn't know what was going on or like how I was supposed to handle it. And then I remember it was the summer holidays of 2016, 2017. And that was like the first time I ever got the feeling or the need to want to throw my food up. It was just like an overwhelming sensation in my brain. And I tried. Mum and dad were at work and I was the only one at home. I was crying. I was like, how could I have done that? Like, that was so silly. That was very like out of character and erratic for me to even like act on the thoughts that I was having. In my mind, I was like, I'm never gonna do that again. Like, I'm never gonna do it again, ever. And then the next day, the exact same thing happened and I did it. And then that's kind of when it all started and started like really going downhill, like from there, in regards to like my mental health and my bulimia and that in general. It gets so addictive because it becomes your release. So I'd get so anxious and so built up, and all of a sudden I just find myself binging on whatever I could get my hands on. And then you would feel such a shame and such guilt for what you've done that you vomit and you release all the tension and all the stress and stuff that you had been feeling. But yeah, it just got worse and worse for me. And once every 2 weeks turned into 3 times a week, 4 times a week, every day, 3 times a day. Like, it became all consuming in my life. Like, I was too scared to go out and eat with friends because I was scared that I'll do that. And it's about how it can control you and how it can put you into such a dark and isolated place. You need to think of it as like almost like a separate entity trying to put you down and trying to fight you and trying to make you feel like you're nothing. And in my mind, I was like trapped. I was stuck in a vicious cycle that I didn't know how to get out of. And I thought I did know how to get out of it. So I was like, all right, I'm gonna, you know, really put all my energy into football now. I'm gonna, you know, eat really healthy and, you know, then it'll stop. And it didn't stop, it just went, flipped and went the other direction. And then instead of binging and purging, I just stopped eating altogether. My moment where I knew that I could have really lost my life was like when my mum and dad, we went shopping one day, and like my thing is wasn't allowed to like look up the calories or look up, you know, whatever's in whatever. And I was sneakily doing it that whole day, and my mum and dad caught me, and I was getting angry because I was like, I'm not even doing anything wrong, like, you don't know. And my mum and dad were like, turned around and said to me, they're like, you know, you don't get to say that. Like, you can't say that. Like, we nearly lost you. Like, Chelsea, you don't even understand what you look like, and you don't even understand how close you are to not even having a life anymore. And I think that moment was like the moment I knew that I literally, like, I could have died.
If they play short, okay, you go in full speed, put pressure, and you come inside half hard.
It didn't really turn positive, or I guess like my life started to feel like my own again, probably until like towards the end of year 12, I had gotten asked to trial for Melbourne City. And, you know, a week before the season, I was told that I was getting signed, and I couldn't believe it, I cried.
And the youngster, Chelsea Blissett, coming on for Melbourne City.
Ever since the get-go, they've made me feel like this is my family. I've always felt supported and cared for, and I know that, you know, if I'm struggling, they're going to be here for me. And whether that be on or off the field, whether that be mental health or whether that be just because I'm having a bad day at training or anything like that. So that really is what the club means to me, and I love being here, and I couldn't picture being anywhere else.
In the right place at the right time, as Chelsea Blissett has made a good return to the Liberty A-League this year.
Football for me saved my life, as in it gave me something to fight for, and it gave me something to believe in, and it showed me my self-worth and everything. And 5 months later, I was playing for the Young Matildas, and it just was surreal, and I couldn't believe it, and I couldn't believe that 6 months ago I was relapsing, and then at the end of that year I was playing with some of my idols in that team. So I think that was definitely a big turning point for me. I've always struggled to talk about it because of the shame that I felt around it, and I always thought it's a subject that hasn't been talked about a lot, and it's a subject that I feel does need to be talked about, and that's why I'm talking about it now, because the pain and the loss that it can cause you is unbelievable. And I'm just lucky that I had people around me that was so supportive and wanted me to live my life and understood the value of my life when I didn't. And you know, I just don't want any little girl to be like sitting down thinking that she's not worth it, or what she's going through was like wrong. Because like I think of myself and it breaks my heart, and it would break my heart more if I didn't speak up about it to try and at least raise some awareness or help one little girl, because like it is heartbreaking like what anyone has to go through, doesn't matter like what it is, like any type of mental illness. Like I just want people to know that they can speak up and that it is okay to speak up, because it's horrible. Like I would never wish this upon anyone. I'm just looking forward to, you know, just what life has in store for me. I'm learning a lot to live in the now and to not put so much pressure on myself, because I am still very perfectionist driven, and I'm just excited to see like what my future has to hold, and I'm excited to see where football goes coming back from my ACL, and you know, excited just to keep growing and being the best version of myself, because I think that's all I can ask for. And I'm just, you know, excited for the future, because, you know, it just looks bright.